Hi, I'm Becky Bruin, and this is my channel. I fell hard for the Great British Bake Off when it was still showing on PBS. My work situation at the time was hard, and my relationship was hard, and the Great British Bake Off just met me where I was, with creativity and community and hilarity and a whole bunch of really nice people. I sometimes say that the Bake Off changed my life, which is actually true, because after I watched a couple seasons, I made my first French pastry, the mini pear pie from season 5. This is the only photo I still have of that baking project. Then I made my first sourdough starter. I made cakes without a box mix, many, many cakes. I had a British-themed Christmas with sausage rolls, veal and ham pie, and Mary Berry's Christmas cake, and I recreated technical challenges. Now I say I, but I actually recruited every person in my life who was willing to play with me. My most loyal enlistees were my friends Ward and Linda, and they each got a wedding cake. One thing I did do alone was I applied to be on the Great American Baking Show. My application got me to the next level, and then to the next level, and then I got to the next level. And then on March 13th, 2020, I was in a plane flying into LA with baked goods in hand for the show's producers. And while I was in the air, they closed the LA school district because of COVID-19. So that was the end of that dream. But you know, the pandemic was not the end of baking. In fact, it was the beginning of a boom. So I started my year of baking dangerously. Every month, I would bake a kind of an elaborate bake and video it. My interest in videography just skyrocketed and finally outpaced my interest in baking. So I quit my job and I started my own videography business. So when I say the Bake Off changed my life, it did. Today, when I watch the Bake Off, I love the baking and the bakers, of course, but I also watch for the storytelling, the way it's done, the way it's changed, and the way it has stayed exactly and satisfyingly the same. Bake Off was a brainchild of public television, so it began with an educational bent. Each episode was set in a different town and would explore the local baking traditions. By the time Americans were really cluing into the Great British Bake Off, it had become the show that it is now, but it was still rooted in English countryside baking. The baker's life story biographies were focused on where they were from in England.
This Paul is a prison governor in Swansea. He's a penchant for sugarcraft, but today...
Just so British. The bakers were on the show because they loved to bake, and they were sometimes completely unaware of the reach of the show. They were competing for the honor and an etched cake plate. This changed a bit with Candice from season 7. Candice was a remarkable baker. She could kind of whip things up at the last minute and they would be gorgeous. Flashy and extremely talented. Quick side note, Linda and I tried to make Candice's Danish pastry. An apple, custard, sultana, orange, cinnamon, Danish. It took us 7 hours. It's hard to know if it was the editing or what, but Paul Hollywood seemed to be smitten with Candice. And because the rumors were that his marriage was on the rocks, there was a lot of attention on her and on that relationship. And when the show was over, it turned out she was completely ready to capitalize on that. The lipsticks, the dramatic lipsticks that she had worn on the show turned into a business. She was feted and featured and promoted, and she ended up becoming somewhat of a celebrity. Now, there had always been opportunities before that. Nadia from season 6 is still very popular, and there are many cookbooks out there by the alum. But after Candice, contestants came onto the show with agents and handlers already lined up, ready to make a splash along with their Victoria sponge. And that has changed the stakes. If you are beautiful enough or interesting enough or likable enough, you can make some money afterwards. And I think it changed the storytelling of the show a little bit. It focused a little less on where they were from and more on their personality and the relationships in the tent and their likability. The bake-off formula is very well known. Contestants come to the tent with fears and hopes. The signature tests their recipe building. The technical tests their depth of knowledge. And the showstopper tests construction and decoration. We have a few yucks, someone's the star baker, someone goes home. The contestants themselves are, or should be, very familiar with the formula. But sometimes you get a contestant saying something like,
I'm meant to practice like my exams, I've just finished my exams.
Or,
if you'd had the week I've had at school, you'd know why I haven't practiced anything.
Or,
when did you decide to change your recipe?
I wrote it yesterday morning.
Yesterday.
I do wonder, though, if the familiarity is a little boring to the camera crew. They must have a natural desire for a new shot or a new angle or a new something. And I do notice when a shot is different, an interesting angle, a little flair. Something shows in the background. I enjoy the blur swish from the drawing to the baking, which I noticed and thought, oh, isn't that cool? And then realized they've been doing that the whole time. Probably the most unvarying camera work is the technical challenge. The judges and the hosts say the same thing every week. And then Paul and Mary, or Paul and Prue, walk down the line, and the hosts just stand quietly at the end. And because of that, the technical bake itself becomes the story. In an early season, the technical challenge was scones, which that would just never happen now. The technical challenges now are photogenic, perilous, and they have a story attached to them, how the recipe was chosen or where they think that the bakers will have trouble. Maybe because of that constraint, we do see a lot of different shots during the technical challenge. Focus changes, high angle shot, long shot, close up, extreme close up, low angle, over the shoulder, pan down, tracking shot, hip shot, shallow focus, overhead. I enjoy seeing the camera add a little freshness to the technical challenge. Editing a reality TV show must be so fun. They get the raw material, they know who wins, they figure they probably have some nuggets in there, and they get to make a story out of it. But it's also an ethical process because lots of different stories could get told from that footage, some of them more truthful than others. One of the most astonishing editing manipulations was from Diana on season 5. Bingate, as it is now known, was one of those really hot days in the tent. The contestants were having a very hard time getting their ice cream cakes to freeze, and kind of toward the end, one of the bakers threw his ice cream cake in the bin. The camera loves who it loves, and the guy who dumped his ice cream was handsome and bearded and very forgivable. Diana was his fellow contestant, and she was a little odd, and she was very unsympathetic to him when this happened. And the editors chose to make it look like she had sabotaged his cake by taking it out of the freezer. Diana was excoriated in the press and on social media, and viewers actually demanded an investigation by the British equivalent of the FCC. They concluded that there just was not enough freezer space, and that one of the other contestants had left the freezer door open while he was decorating his cake, even though he was asked multiple times to close it. Luckily for Diana, she is not on social media, because that episode is still out there. People still see it, and they still hate her for ruining the bearded man's ice cream cake. But most of the editing manipulations are more fun. For instance, the 1 minute warning.
1 minute, 5 minutes,
because you have 1 minute,
30 seconds.
It gets called and the music swells and the camera just heaves and we're dizzy from all of the close-ins and zooms out. It can be very exciting television if you let yourself forget that it's just editing. The Great British Bake Off story is part of my story. I follow all of the contestants on social media. Early on, I created a glossary of Bake Off terms and an Excel spreadsheet of all of the bakes. But mostly the Bake Off helped me reconnect with my ambitions and helped me remember who I am. I still get asked if I'm going to open a bakery, and sadly, no, I'm not. That's not gonna be part of my story. But I will always love Bake Off and the bakers, and whipping up a technical challenge or two. Bye. See you next time.